Hello everyone, welcome to this webinar on post-tension box girder balance cantilever bridge. In the next 30 to 45 minutes, I'll be going through the different relevant aspects of superstructure design for a balance cantilever bridge. My name is Abhishek and I'm a structural engineer at AECOM. So in the webinar today, we'll go through, first of all, a brief introduction of the bridge itself that we're going to pick up today. Then design actions, structural analysis aspects, where we'll talk about the analysis, numerical analysis that we did using the software Midas Civil, and construction sequence analysis, and finally the important design aspects related to the superstructure. Okay, so a little bit about the site itself. So the bridge that we are going to take is the balance cantilever bridge, part of the Jakarta Metro CP102 package. It's between the proposed stations Fatmawati and Sipit Raya. It's over an existing flyover JORR. That's the typical span, how it looks like in plan. Horizontally curved, and you have three span with two monolithic intermediate piers. The entire structure is supported on port piles. That's the span arrangement. We have three spans, typically 47, 77 and 49 meters between the end bearings. The piers FP1 to FP4, the piers that we are talking about, FP2 and FP3, the two intermediate piers are in alignment with the flyover itself, so they are highly skewed with respect to the superstructure, and they are monolithic at the same time. Cross section information: the overall width of the deck is 10.13 meters, spacing between the track center lines, which carries the metro carriage, is 4.2 meters, and overall depth varies. It's got a tapered profile from the pier location, where the depth is 4.7 meters, to the mid span or the end span location, where the depth is 2.7 meters. Similarly, web thickness varies to take care of the shear considerations. The piers and foundations are mostly columns, single columns. The intermediate piers are circular columns of 5 meter diameter, and typically heights vary from 16 to 19 meters. End piers FP1 and FP4 are rectangular in cross section and have a pier cap at the top to support the deck. The piles are also having different diameters under different piles, so the heavier loads will come on the FP2 and FP3, so they have a larger dia pile of 1.5 meters. Material grades used in the structure include C40, that is cylindrical strength, 40 MPa of concrete for most of the superstructure, including the pier crossheads, the pile caps, precast segments. Here we are using in situ segments, so for the in situ segments also C40 has been used. For pre-stressing steel, typical 7 strand 15.7 nominal dia tendons are used. We are using two types of tendons, 17K15 and 19K15 in this example. Then ultimate strength is 1860 MPa, Young's modulus is 195 GPa. And reinforcing bars as per the Jakarta Metro specifications in Indonesia is 390 MPa for the main rebars. Okay, now let's talk about the design actions that were considered in this design of the bridge. Permanent actions including self-weight and SIDL. SIDL consists of a lot of components such as your precast parapet, railings, plinth, sleepers for the tracks, and drainage screed as well. So in Midas, that is the numerical package that is used for the design of this bridge, these loads are all inputted in the form of line beam loads, as the analysis type that we